Hey everybody, it's John, Tinker John, and welcome here to the shop. It's going to be a two-part video. We're going to split it up in about 5 or 10 minute videos each one. And we're going to go through making these little spark plugs here that go with internal combustion engines. Now, you can buy these spark plugs, as you know, but they're getting rather expensive. They're upwards to $20 now. And now those spark plugs that you buy, they are very good spark plugs. There's no doubt about that. I'll also say that these spark plugs right here, even though they might not last quite as long as one that you'll buy, if you spend your time on them, they look authentic and they work really good, and you've got the pride of actually making the spark plug yourself. And that way you can tell somebody, I made the engine all the way to the carburetor and the spark plug. Join me over here at the bench. It's a two-part series. The first one, we're going to talk about the end down here, how you make the base. The second half, we'll make the insulator and the electrode that goes down through the middle. So, as I said, join me over the lathe and we'll go through turning the base of the model engine spark plug. One of the first things you're going to do whenever you start making your spark plug is find out a source for hex stock. Now, there's a couple of ways you can do this. You can buy hex stock, or you can do what I do, and I use one of these 5C collet holders right here. And they come in a set. You've got a square block and you've got a hex block, and they're just extremely beneficial and extremely helpful around the shop. And the reason they're so helpful is this round stock, as you know, is going to be a lot less expensive than the square stock that you the hex stock. So I keep several sizes of this. I keep 3/8, 1/4 inch, 1/2 inch on hand, and that way I can essentially make any type of hex stock that I want. But if you don't have a set of this right here, I encourage you to get a set. I'll put a link down below in the video that'll give you a chance to do that. I am an Amazon affiliate, so if you order, you know, I'll make a couple of pennies off that. Doesn't cost you anything more. But once you get your hex stock, either that you've bought as a hex stock or you have turned into hex stock by round, go ahead and put that in your machine. Now, what I typically do is I'll do one of these round bars, and I'll usually put it in the milling machine. I'll do about 2 inches back. I've made several bases on this one, so I'll just continue working with what I have. The first thing we're going to do is just turn down the outside diameter to 1/4 inch, and we're going to manually thread that. Not manually thread, but I'll just use 1/4 inch die. Going to go in 1/4 inch diameter and go up 1/4 inch to the shoulder on this. So I'll start doing that. When I get that turned, we'll come back and we'll do the threading. What I've got here is 1/4 by 32 die. I use the tailstock die holder that I've made. They're easy to make. I really encourage you to make one. And all it does is just slides along this rod here, and you can actually pulse the lathe and go ahead and get it started to make those threads. Now, after I've run the die up on one end, what I do is I just take it and I reverse the die, and that way I can get just a little bit up closer to the shoulder. Now, the next step is just drill a 1/8 inch hole through about 3/4 inch. So I'm going to go ahead and get everything set up and we'll do that. Now, the next operation is to part this off, and you're going to part it off to an overall length of 1/2 inch, or put about 1/4 inch shoulder on it up through there. So you've got your 1/8 inch hole gone through. Now it's just time to part it off to an overall length of 1/2 inch. All right, so the next step, that's going to come off, of course, hot. So I'm going to let that cool just a minute. Then we're going to turn around, reverse that in the chuck. Now, the next step is to take the part that you've made. You put your threads at the bottom, you've got your shoulder at the top. Go ahead and put it in the lathe chuck with the shoulder out. Threads will be towards the inside, and go ahead and clamp up. And then I'm going to take a little chamfering tool here and knock out that swarf. After that's knocked out, then come in and drill 1/4 inch deep with a 1/4 inch drill bit, 1/4 by 1/4, because you remember you got 1/4 inch threads on the other side. If you drill through, you're just going to knock your piece in two. So get that set up. I'm going to re-zero the DRO and just come in 1/4 inch. Now, take that out. maybe hot. No, it's not. So you've completed the base with one exception. We'll take it over and blacken it with some oil. But that's your spark plug base right there. Quarter by 32, 1/8 inch that way, quarter inch this way. And I use JB Weld. You can use epoxy, but JB Weld will hold the insulator in just fine. And we'll do that on part two. Okay, back at the bench here, gonna change up just a little bit. What I have over here is just motor oil, and I shouldn't keep it in a glass. I know somebody's gonna comment on that, but I just use this small stuff. Been doing it for years and years and years, and it seems to work just fine. But we're gonna blacken it now. I'll just open up this torch, give it a shot. All you gotta do is just get it red hot. By the way, you're gonna use a pair of pliers that you really don't care about ruining, because you're going to take the temper out of these pliers. But just get it red hot. Propane torch is plenty. You don't need anything like MAP or anything like that. And then drop it in. Let it cool off a little bit. Get it back out and do it again. Just do it three or four times. Now, it's fixing to catch on fire now, but it'll only burn for just a minute. As soon as all that oil gets burned off of it, it'll heat right back up again. Now, I'm not hardening any or doing anything special to this. This is just hot rolled steel was what it was. Then drop it in again. And I usually do it about three times. So I'll go ahead and do it one more time. Hard to see down in there while I got the camera and everything on. All right. And I'm gonna do it one more time. And that's all you have to do to get a nice blackened color to your base part. And what you have is just a nice black sheen that'll look really good on your internal engine. That's going to wrap it up for part one. We'll come back to part two. We'll go ahead and build the insulator. Well, that wraps it up for part one of the series on making the little model engine spark plug. And we covered the base. Next time, come back, we'll be working on the top portion or the insulator portion of the spark plug. If you haven't already got some, try rounding up some Corian. I got mine from a local cabinet shop, just went by, struck a conversation up and asked for a few scrap pieces, and they obliged by giving me that. So hopefully you'll find some by then. And we'll see on the next video as we complete making the model engine spark plug. Until we meet again, Tinker John, and we'll catch you on the next video. Yeah.